Let's get started. It's a pleasure to have with us David Duarte and Maslum Tosun. David is a data architect at Sphere, and Maslum is a consultant who is currently in the last couple of years as technical lead for Google Cloud Platform. So they will share with us how they some best practices for exception management with Apache Beam. So having said that, please, David and Maslum, it's a pleasure to have you with us. Feel free to get started.
Thanks. Thanks, Pedro. Hello, everyone. So today, Maslum and myself will speak about exception management inside Beam. Okay. So let's start. So here is a basic streaming ingestion pipeline. So it's a good use case to present the big data challenge we are facing when we are doing big data. Okay. So we have on this use case a factory which a lot of machines which emit a lot of events, data from sensor, machine, and so on. And we want to ingest all this data onto BigQuery for analytics and perhaps machine learning use case. So this data is pushed to PubSub. And after transformed inside Dataflow, which is the Google implementation of Apache Beam, and pushed into Google BigQuery. So this use case is very interesting because we are facing a different challenge. First, since in factories we have a lot of different machines, we have a variety of data formats. Okay, so each machine has its own format, each sensor has its own format. So we have some variety of format. Also, since we have a lot of machines, we have a challenge of volume of data, because if all machines are emitting events, we need to handle correctly the volume. We also have an issue on velocity. Okay, so one big challenge is to be able to handle all this data, perhaps because we have real-time use cases and we take decision near real-time. And the last big challenge we have here is the veracity of the data. So is my data consistent? Okay? So all these big challenge, so variety, volume, velocity, veracity, to best do them, we need a good exception management. So what is the common error when we are ingesting data? First, as I said on the use case, we have a lot of machines, so a lot of data formats. And what can happen is a machine vendor upgrades his firmware, and we have a new version of the input format. So when we ingest this data, the input format can be wrong. Also, we can have issues with the output format. For example, you store using the data in BigQuery, and it's not Apache Beam or Dataflow which is creating the BigQuery schema. It's another component, for example, a Terraform. And perhaps what can happen is the format has changed, your code hasn't changed, and so you'll have issues in storing the data into BigQuery. Also, you can have errors when you are implementing your data pipeline. Okay, your data pipeline can contain bugs. You'll do your best effort to do unit test, end-to-end test, but we are human, so sometimes we introduce bugs. Okay, and the business code you are implementing can contain errors. Okay, also when you develop you use third-party libraries, and also these libraries can contain bugs. For example, you use some connectors, and one connector to a database have an issue, and it can be possible. And last thing is you can have failures when you are interacting with external systems. For example, you are calling APIs. The API you are calling is failed or is transmitting an error. Okay, you can also connect into databases, and your database have issue in connections. So you can have this kind of errors. Okay, if you don't manage these errors, you can have issues. Okay, first, the data loss. Okay, so your data is you need to persist your data. If, for example, you don't manage correctly the errors, what can happen is you have a part of your message which is stored into BigQuery, and the error message lost. Okay, so it can be a problem. Okay, also, if you don't manage correctly your errors, and you don't log correctly the errors in a standardized manner, you cannot analyze correctly the errors, and it can be a mess when you are in production to understand what is happening inside your jobs. Okay, and also, if you don't have a good error management, you cannot monitor efficiently the platform. For example, you have a data flow job, so a BIM job, which is failing. So you have errors growing. If you don't have a standardized way to manage this kind of errors, you are not able to see if the errors are growing, and if you have to stop the job, so it's an issue. So how we manage common errors? The principle is to implement dead letter queues. So what we do is when an error occurs, we catch the error, we store the message, its context, and the associated error message on a sync. Okay, it can be a topic, a PubSub topic, or inside BigQuery, you sync the error. Since you are implementing a system of dead letter queues, what you are able to do is to monitor the error syncs. For example, to see if your BigQuery table containing the error is growing. If it is growing, you can trigger alerts. And you can have sophisticated systems, which, for example, if the errors grows quickly, automatically you stop the job because it can be a big issue, okay? So you can put this kind of monitoring with things. So what is the implementation, the guidelines inside Apache Beam? So inside Apache Beam, what we do is for each stage, so in each transform we do on our data pipeline, we need to add a try catch block to handle the error. When there is error, we get the error, we store the message and the error in a side output, and after we persist the side output as a sync somewhere, BigQuery or PubSub, for example. There is some implementation issues related. Okay, since you are doing some try catch on each stage or your data pipeline, what can happen is your code is difficult to read, okay, and maintain. And also, if you you don't manage correctly your errors, you have to pass on all your data pipeline to fix the error management you have done. Okay, so this is my introduction about error management. So now I will let Mazloum speak about an initiative he has about exception management inside Beam and how to manage it efficiently. So Mazloum, I let you speak.
Thanks, David. Good morning, everyone. It's a pleasure for me to be here with you. The purpose of this presentation, as David said, is to talk about native error handling with Apache Beam and comparison between approaches. And as David said, I'm going to talk about a library that I create this time in order to centralize some part of code and to simplify error handling with Apache Beam. Firstly, I'm going to talk about error handling with Pardoo and DoFN. Beam recommends treating error with a dead letter queue. It means catching error in the flow and using side output, and then sync the output to a database or other. In this case, in the DoFN, we have the principle of tuple tags. We can see an example here. We have a failure object, for example. This failure object contains an input element, is the input element of the current transformation in the flow. The failure can contain also the current occurred exception in the flow, and maybe the pipeline step. Here you can see DoFN class. In order to be able to write a DoFN class in Apache Beam, we need to extend the DoFN class proposed by Beam. Here in this example, the input of the current transformation is a string and the output is an integer. In order to be able to process the transformation, we have to override a process element method. And via the current process context, we can recover the current input element via context.element. And when we write context.output, it will automatically return the success output tag. And then, as David said previously, we write a try catch block here, and in the catch block we can get the current occurred error if there is one, and we can instantiate the failure object from the current step, for example, the current input element and the current throwable. Then when we call context.output, we can pass the failure tags here and the previous built failure object. This DoFN class can then expose the output tag and the failure tags. It's a native way to write a DoFN class with error handling on try catch block. Then in the flow, we have an input pay collection, for example, a word pay collection. We instantiate the previous DoFN class, word count DoFN. And after this, we call the input pay collection dot apply. And then with the Pardoo of DoFN, with tuple tags, we can recover a pay collection tuple because all the principle of Beam is based on the pay collection and transformation. here how our transformation is the work count fn. And via tuple tags, after this, we can recover the output and good p collection result and the failure p collection. And we can, after this, with the dead letter queue, sync, for example, the failure collection, for example, in a topic or a database for analytics. Okay. After this, I'm going to talk about native map elements and flat map elements proposed by Apache Beam. We can, with these native elements, deal with error via exception into method and exception via method. In the exception into, we give the precision of the current output failure class. And if an error occurred behind the scene, Apache Beam in this native element catch the error for us and give us an exception element object that contains the input element and the current occurred exception. After this, we have access to the result structure, and this result structure, we can get the output pay collection and the failure pay collection too. Pedro, maybe there is a question. I saw a hand.
No. There is a raised hand. There's a Q&A. Ayush asks us, when data doesn't match with BigQuery data types, data get discarded and we never know which data is not inserted into BigQuery. How we will know which data is not being inserted into BigQuery?
If a data is not inserted to BigQuery?
Uh-huh. Like if a data doesn't match the data types, if something doesn't type the data types, then the data is discarded. So Ayush is asking if there is a way to know which data was discarded because it didn't match any of the data types.
Well, I understand the question. For example, here with the exception handling, the data that doesn't match a type or that containing an error will be caught, and then the data is not lost because is taken by the pay collection of failure, and after this the pay collection of failure can be synced in other BigQuery table for analytics.
Okay.
For example, and after this, we can query this dedicated table for failures, and we can recover all the elements that for example, can't be inserted to BigQuery by the normal and good output.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you.
I'm going to show you the comparison between approaches. Here, we can see the usual Beam pipeline without error handling. We have an input pay collection. We call a first map element, okay? And then we call a second kind of transformation that is a flat map element. And after this, we call a third transformation with word count fn. After this, I'm going to show you the same flow with error handling in each step. If we want to deal with error in each step, for example, in the first transformation, we have the map element with exception into and exception via proposed natively by Beam. After this, we can recover the first output and the first failure pay collection. Then we call a flat map element with exception into and exception via, and again get output two and failure two. And here the third example with the the custom DoFM class and tuple tags, and we can recover output tree and failure tree. And at the end, we can concat all the failures here. What are the problems with this approach? We lose the native fluent style on apply chains because we have to handle output and errors for each step. For map element and flat map element, we have to always add exception into an exception via, and this code can be centralized. For each custom DoFN, we have to duplicate the code of tuple tag logic, and we have to duplicate the track edge block, and also it can be centralized. The code is verbose, and there is no centralized code to concat all the errors. We have to concat all failures, and it can be centralized too. Here, I'm going to show you the same flow with error handling, but using the Asgard library. With the Asgard library, we have a class named called Collection Composer. Collection Composer is created from an input pay collection here. And then we can call the first transformation with map element into, and behind the scene, the exception into and exception via are added by the Collection Composer wrapper class. And after this, we can chain the second transformation that is a flat map element with the same principle behind the scene. We can add the exception into an exception via. And the third transformation, Asgard proposed some custom DoFN classes, for example, a map element FN, flat map element FN, and filter FN. With these classes, we can, with the same principle, a native component proposed by BIM, we can call into with ties descriptor and via with a lambda expression for the transformation. The advantage of these classes are we can interact with the BIM lifecycle methods like start bundle, finish bundle, or others. At the end, we call a get result method. The result method gives us a with failure result structure that gives the possibility to recover the output pay collection and the failure pay collection. After this, which is the purpose of this library? Wrap all error handling logic in the composer class. Wrap exception into an exception via usage in the native BIM classes map element and flat map element. All this logic is wrapped in the composer class. Keep the fluent style natively proposed by BIM in apply method while checking for failure, and offer a less verbose way of error handling. Expose custom DoFN classes with centralized try-catch block and tuple tags. There is no centralized code now to concat all the errors, and we have to concat all failures. It's proposed by Asgard internally. And an easier access to lifecycle method, as I said before. And we propose also a component called FilterFN that allows us to add error handling with a filter component. It's not currently available in the filter by native component. Also, Asgard proposed some extensions on Kotlin. Why Kotlin? Apache Beam Java is great, but sometimes we can use Apache Beam with Kotlin that allow us to have less verbose code, for example, and Kotlin is a great language for immutability and to work more easily with null fields. And I had an idea to propose some extension for a collection composer class for Kotlin with methods that are more functional programming oriented. For example, is the same flow as I shown before, previously. We have here a map directly with lambda expression here. We can then chain with a flat map with a lambda expression. And the equivalent of map element fn component is a dot map fn function. And also here, we can pass a lambda expression. The advantage of Kotlin extension are we can add methods and behavior on existing structure without affecting the structure. And if I want to mix the extension proposed for Kotlin with the native code proposed for Collection Composer, I can, for example, here call map and then call dot apply with flat map element into via, et cetera, and that's why I think the extension for Kotlin is interesting too. If we want to use this extension, we only have to add the following import in our code, asgard.star, and at the end we call the results. Here I'm going to show you an example of Dataflow DAG with a good sync here at the bottom and two bad sync at the left. We can see a bad sync that recover the failure pay collection and write it to BigQuery for analytics, for example. And here we have the same failure pay collection, and we write this failure pay collection to Cloud Login, for example. As David said previously, the advantage of writing failures to Cloud Login is to monitor easily errors, and after this we can, for example, trigger alerting. Here, I'm going to show you an example of alerting policy. For example, when the error is written to Cloud Login with a pattern, for example, after this, it's easy to add a log-based metric and alerting policy that filter the pattern. And after this, we can have an email, and from this email, we can access to Cloud Login. I can show you an example from an email here. Do you see my email? Alerting email.
Yes.
For example, here I have created an alerting policy, Dataflow job intercepted errors. Here I have a description of the alerting policy. And at the bottom, I can access to the associated log. And when I click here, I can access to Log Explorer. And from Cloud Login, I have access to all the failures from a flow. For example, I have the input element here with the JSON form and the associated stack trace here. For example, I have a stack trace that indicated that brand and country, maybe in the current structure, is not good and contains, it doesn't exist from a referential. Okay, it's okay for me. Do you have a question maybe? And thank you.
Yes, Pedro.
Oh, no, I just wanted to thank you, Maslam. The main question we have is availability for Python.
Yes, It's a good question. Thanks, Pedro. I've written the Python version 2 of Asgard is under the development. I pushed the first version in my GitHub repository, but I wanted to add more description from the README file to explain more the library. And I will communicate about the Python version very soon. And it's very interesting for me to have feedbacks from the community. And don't hesitate to contribute to this library for the Java version and the Python version too. But yes, I'm going to share with the BIM community the Python version 2 of Asgard, because there is the same concern from the Python BIM pipelines. And for example, now in my actual customer, we have a hybrid BIM pipelines with Kotlin and Python. And now we use Asgard from Java, Kotlin, and Python too.
Okay, thank you so much, Maslum and David. Thanks everybody for joining us, and see you in the next session from BIM College.